I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody about somebody that can save everybody. I'm excited about it. It ain't about me, it's about you.
Sharing God's word, praise, worship, and honor to meet you at your need and where you stand. Continuing the tradition, you are listening to Praise On. We thank you for listening to this edition of Praise On. On this edition, we would like to celebrate the life and memory of Muhammad Ali. Both of us as producers were big fans of Muhammad Ali back in the day. From the beginning of his career up until the very end, Muhammad Ali, of course, was a three-time world boxing champion, as well as a great humanitarian and a champion for equal rights and equality here in the United States as well as around the world. What we would like to do is play an excerpt from a concert, basically a conversation he had with some children of about 500 in England back in 1972. The children wanted to know what he wanted to do when he retired, and this is his reply. We hope you enjoyed. We celebrate his life, and you are listening to Praise On.
I'd like to know what you're going to do when you retire from boxing.
I think he's probably taking the last count at the moment. I'll do my best to wake him up.
Just sleep.
For you.
That's all I'm gonna do.
That's all he wants to do when he retires.
Now, when I retire from boxing, I really don't know. I want to say something right here. This might make you all think. Life is not really long. Let's say the average person 30 years old. If you're 30 years old, you are not but about 7 years old. How can I prove it? Add up all the 7, 8, 9 hours you slept for 30 years. Out of 30 years, add up all the nights, last night when you went to bed and woke up this morning, you don't remember a thing. You've been unconscious for about 8 years. If you're 30 years old, you slept about 8 years. Okay. How much traveling have you done in 30 years? From the television station to home, to another country, to another city, to school, to church. You've probably traveled 2 years of your life or spent just getting back and forth to where you're going. So there's 8 years of sleeping, 2 years of traveling, there's 30 years out of your life before you accomplish anything. How long do you sit in school? In America, we stay in school from the 12th grade to from the first grade to 12th grade. Same here?
Yeah, virtually.
6 hours a day?
Yeah.
6 hours a day for 12 years, break it down, you sit in a classroom for 3 years without leaving. Okay, 2 years of traveling, 8 years of sleeping, 3 years of school. How many movies have you went to? How many wrestling matches? How much entertainment? How many movie theaters, live plays, baseball games? Probably 2 years of entertainment. So by the time a man, you older people know him, bear witness what I'm saying, by the time you have children, by the time you have made a way for your children, by the time you've paid for your home, you're pushing 60 years old. So life is real short. So you add up all your traveling, add up all your sleeping, add up all your school, add up all your entertainment, you've probably been half your life doing nothing. So what am I, I'm 35 years old, 30 more years I'll be 65. We don't have no more influence. We can't do nothing much at 65. Your wife will tell you that. So what I'm saying, when you're 65, ain't too much more to do. So did you know I'll be 65 in 30 more years? In those 30 years, I have to sleep 9 years. I don't have 30 years of daylight. I have to travel back to America, take 6, 7 miles. All my traveling, probably 4 years of traveling in the next 30 years. About 9 years of sleeping. Television, movies, entertainment, about 3 years of entertainment. Out of 30 years, I might have about 16 years to be productive. So it's how we can all break individual lives down. What am I going to do in the next 16 years? What's the best thing I can do? Get ready to meet God. Owning real estate, going in business, teaching boxers, that won't get me to heaven. How many here believe there's a supreme being, believe there's a God? How many believe there's some power that made the sun, the moon, the stars? How many believe that this stuff didn't just come out here? Somebody wiser than us made it. How many believe there's a God? How many believe there's not a God? All right. Believe there's not a God. All right. If I told you, you who don't believe in God, if I told you that this glass sprang into existence, this glass made itself, no man made this glass, would you believe it? Would you believe I just told you this thing made itself?
No.
When I tell you, you wouldn't believe it, right?
No, somebody's doubting it, yeah. So I'm giving you the answer.
Wouldn't believe it. If I told her this television station popped into existence, it just, no man made it. You said Muhammad Ali's crazy. All right. Well, if this glass can't make itself, if I told you those clothes you have on wove themselves, nobody created them, those clothes made themselves, you wouldn't believe it. But if your clothes didn't make itself, if that glass couldn't make itself, if this building didn't make itself, then how did the moon get out there? How did the stars and Jupiter, Neptune and Mars and the sun, how did nature, how did all this come here if didn't know why is something planning to make it? So what I'm saying is, I believe that we're going to be judged. Should a man like Hitler kill all the Jews and get away with it? Somebody should punish him. Maybe he get it. Don't get it now, he get it when he die. In hell for eternity. So what I'm going to do when I get out of boxing is to get myself ready to meet God, because my plane might blow up. Don't planes blow up in this country sometime and crash? Don't people die every day?
Every day.
It's a scary thing to think that I'm going to hell to burn eternally forever. So what am I going to do? I'm explaining what you asked me a question. You asked me questions I can't just answer like that. When I get out of boxing or when I'm through, I'm going to do all I can to help people. That's why I'm here with Johnny Walker. Here's a poor man, came all the way to America. Here's a bunch of boys need some money, and somebody is calling me to help them. God is watching me. God don't praise me because I beat Joe Frazier. God don't give nothing about Joe Frazier. God don't care nothing about England or America as far as your wealth is all his. He wants to know, how do we treat each other? How do we help each other? So I'm going to dedicate my life to using my name and popularity, helping charities, helping people, uniting people, people bumming each other because of religious beliefs. We need somebody in the world to help make peace. So when I die, if there's a heaven, I want to see it. Because we live how long? 80 years? The odds are everybody in this room, some of you going to be dead 20 years from now. Some of you going to be dead 50 years from now. Some are going to be dead 30, some are going to be dead 60, 70 years now. We all going to die soon. And if you live to be, say, 125 years old, which we don't do, right? Let's say we live to be 250, and you can have sex for 145 of those years. You're going to come to the end after that. So we don't have but about 80 years on earth. This is a test to see where will we spend our life in heaven and hell. This is not the life now. Your real self is inside you. Your body gets old. Some of you go to look at the fridge, you don't have no teeth. Your hair is leaving you. Your bodies get tired. But your soul and your spirit never die. That's going to live forever. So your body is just housing your soul and spirit. So God is testing us on how we treat each other, how we live, to see where our real home be in heaven. So this physical stuff don't last for so long. So my car, this building is going to be here when the man who built it dead. There have been many kings and queens of England. They're all dead. After this one is gone, another one will come. So we don't stay here. We're just trustees. We don't own nothing. Even your children are not yours, if you think I'm lying. Your wife is not yours. You die and come back a year later and go sleep in your bedroom and see if your wife is by herself. See, you don't own your wife. I divorced my wife. You may have read about it. And my four children, they call another man daddy now. They don't see me no more. You don't own your children. You don't own your family. So what am I saying? The most important thing about life is what's going to happen when you die. Are you going to go to heaven or hell? And that's eternity. How long is eternity? Let's imagine. Take the Sahara Desert. There's a lot of sand on the Sahara Desert, right? Then imagine that one grain of sand represents 1,000 years, and when you're in hell burning, when you die and go to hell, you're going to burn forever and ever, no end. How long is that? Give you an idea how long eternity is. Take the Sahara Desert, and I told you to wait 1,000 years, and every 1,000 years, I want you to pick up a grain of sand until the desert is empty. Okay, wait 1,000 years, pick up the first grain. Wait another 1,000 years before you get the next grain. Keep that up until there's no more sand in the desert. Whew. You know how long America's not but 200 years old. We got 800 more years to go before 1,000. So it just scares me to think that I'm going to die one day and go to hell. I'm on an airplane that might blow up. I'm always traveling. And to go to hell and God is going to judge my soul. The police, I might kill people. I might rob people. The authorities might not catch me. The FBI, Scotland Yard might not catch me. But when I die, somebody's watching me and keeping count. And I can't get away. And I'm going to burn forever and ever and ever. I'll go to heaven. So what am I going to do when I'm through fighting? I only have 16 years to be productive. Get myself ready to meet God and go to the best place. Don't that make sense?
Thank you.
Thank you for listening to Praise On every Sunday morning at 9 o'clock. Our vision statement, sharing God's word, praise, worship, honor, meets you at your need and where you stand. Praise On. Our vision verse, Psalms 146:1. Praise the Lord. Let all that I am praise the Lord.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's not just about the music. It's about meeting you at your need and where you stand. You are listening to Praise On here on KJAM 93.9. Yes.
They thought that I would crumble,
but they were so wrong.
You held my hand and
encouraged me to stand.
And when they said I couldn't do it, I heard you say,
you said yes, she
can.
Gotta
sing it one more time.
Yes. They thought that I'd be weak,
but you made me strong.
You see, they thought that I would crumble. I heard you say,
you said yes, you can.
Yes.
I overcame, oh,
cause you said yes, you can.
And every day I'm getting stronger,
cause you said yes, you can.
Yes.
I'm no longer doubting, no,
cause you said yes, you can.
Now it's my time to tell somebody,
I can do it now.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
Continuing the tradition, you are listening to Praise on KJAM 93.9.
Get everything wondering about your deliverance. Look like it's so long coming. But I want you to know you got to find your comfort zone. And when you find it, get in it. Satan does not belong in front of you where he can lead you. He doesn't belong beside of you where he can whisper in the air. Neither does he belong behind you. But he belongs under your feet. Reach over and touch somebody and tell them he belongs under your feet. Hallelujah. Anyhow, don't let your troubles get you down. Satan block your way. Stand right up and say,
you bumping, man?
Jesus.
Holy Ghost fire.
Praise On Media. If you have a special event, such as church service, wedding, birthday celebrations, anniversary, family gathering, and would like to have it recorded in DVD high definition quality, Praise On Media would love to partner with you and record your special event. You may contact our chairman, Reverend Michael Middlebrooks, our vice chairman, Leonard Middlebrooks, or our public relations director, Shirley Marshall. Remember, Praise On Media, recording all of your special events in high definition quality. Thank you.
You met me deep in my despair to show me you would never leave me there. You claimed me 'cause I was made for so much more. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. Go heavy with the weight of my mistakes. You carried me and refused to let me sink under the pressure. You meant for me to soar. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all you have planned for me, and nothing can separate me from your love. When there's so much more still worth fighting for. Now I'm moving by faith and not by sight towards victory. By the power of your might, you're straightening out my path and opening every door. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for.
Nothing can separate me from your love.
When there's so much more, yeah.
Still worth fighting for.
Eyes haven't seen,
eyes haven't seen,
ears haven't
heard.
All you have planned for me,
and nothing
can separate me from your love. When there's so much more. Still worth fighting for, and that's why I'm
here. I've had the opportunity to introduce some great people, but I want somebody tonight to know I know a man that can't fail. I know a man that works miracles. I know a man that heals, delivers, and sets free. Won't you help me witness and just tell somebody I know a man, I know a man. Regardless of what you're going through, you got to know him for yourself.
I'm trying to make it plain so you understand. But I also want you to get God's word. Don't get caught up on Reverend Mike. I'm just trying to bring you in so you know he'll do it for somebody like me too. Because it can change your life.
Every Sunday morning at 9 o'clock, we invite you to join us for Praise On here on KJAM 93.9.
Social plays the best.
Social clubs. Yeah.
Listen, I relate to kids when they feel left out. I'm sitting all alone, feeling empty in this house. And I think about the nights I spent all by myself. Got too much pride to ever ask you for help. I told my mom whatever that she needs, she can have it. One of three couples I know with a good marriage. My friend and his wife don't even share a mattress. This can't happen to us, baby, it's tragic. I miss when we were all a big family. Get togethers, tell me if you even still think of me. My uncle and I haven't spoken in a second, and I blame him for the bad relationship with my cousin. I lost a pastor, my aunt lost a husband. Feeling is mutual, cause I don't even trust him. And now I put my trust in the God who first loved me. Misfit in my blood, everybody's normal but me.
What is this feeling that I'm feeling when I look at this misfit in the mirror? I feel like I missed it, then it feels like a lie. Now I feel like I'm lying, it's a Sodom and Gomorrah. Morrah, 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 morrah. And this is Sodom and Gomorrah. Morrah, 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 morrah. Yeah.
I went from liquor and pornography to writing jewels about the God in me. I was a fool, even I could see. So why the Lord keep his eye on me? I seen an old friend from around the way. Ay, he said, "Firm, bro, you on your way." Say, I know you from them late nights, Cray. On that get right, hey, and now you make my day. He say, "Never stop believing that my words will reach the children, cause the way I come across, I make them feel that I'm forgiven." Peep that. Said, "The way I come across, I make them feel that I'm forgiven." If you better give the grudge up, short time span, you better off showing love, bruh. Lifestyle did a 180. Would need God greatly, would I feed my baby?
What is this feeling that I'm feeling when I look at this misfit in the mirror? I feel like I missed it, and it feels like a lie. Now I feel like I'm lying, it's a Sodom and Gomorrah. Morrah, 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 morrah. Sodom and Gomorrah, morrah, 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 morrah.
Thank you for listening, and we hope that you got your praise on. This show is produced by Reverend Michael Middlebrook and Leonard C. Middlebrooks. This is a production of Praise On Incorporated.